There's a waffle and some syrup up here, Luke. I'm sure everybody's curious.
I'm still stuck back on Nelson's message.
You are.
I think I got the wrong illustration here. So, I mean, that was powerful, right?
I mean, we can just all go home after that. And say amen, right?
And say amen, yeah. Yes. Let's make it short. We start early, we can go home early.
Amen.
Yeah.
They're supposed to say amen.
Yeah. So I've got a friend, Paul, and he told me about an Australian pastor one time who he would preach the Great Commission, you know, and I'm sure he didn't do it near as well as Nelson did this morning, but he'd preach and preach, and people just come up and say, yeah, brother, but I just don't feel led. I just don't feel led. I just don't feel led. And so one Sunday, he staggered into church with his paper bag with his heavy object in it, and he preached his message on the Great Commission, went to the back of the church, whipped out his paper bag, and as they came through, he said, Pastor, I don't feel led. He had a big hunk of lead. He said, you can feel lead. And the reality is, I'm still stuck. The guy that was up here making announcements, the whole thing about obedience and not feeling the needs, it's not about feeling led, right? So
Amen.
Pull out a pencil, okay? If you want to feel led, just pull out a pencil.
And feel it.
Feel the tip. That'll work. It'll work. You'll feel led, okay? So, yeah, the waffle, this is part of Acts 29. I don't know if you've ever read about waffle theology, but it's in there. It's in the chapter that hasn't been written yet, which is what we're writing, right? We're part of Acts 29, the rest of the story. And, you know, the issue, Merlin, with the waffle is that the church is largely stuck on pancake theology. So I thought we would introduce waffle theology this morning.
Go ahead.
Does that sound like a plan?
That sounds like a plan. Yeah. I mean,
so when I was in school, there was one date that I remembered. I forgot all the other dates, but I did remember 1492. Because we had this little poem that we recited in Canadian history. I don't know if they did it down here or not. But it was in 1492... Columbus sailed the, I'm hearing it, sailed the ocean blue. And back then, the world was flat like a pancake. At least that's what they kind of believed, that if you would go so far, you'd topple off the earth. And everyone was kind of freaked out. But Columbus said, no, I think it's round, and we can get to India and all this kind of stuff. And the unfortunate thing is that we in the Christian world are still stuck back in 1492. Because we think the world is flat like a pancake, the gospel's like syrup, and all we have to do is pour it on the pancake, and it'll spread out over that pancake, and we'll reach the entire globe. In other words, let's just send missionaries into every country in the world, and we will spread the gospel. We will hasten the return of Christ, as it says in Peter, and we will fulfill the Great Commission if we send missionaries to every country in the world. And it's because of a faulty theology. We've got a pancake theology, and the world is like a waffle. I know you didn't believe that, but it is, and it's good theology. It's biblical. I know the Bible doesn't use the word waffle, but I'm going to be talking a little bit this morning about people groups. And biblically, we have to understand the Great Commission is talking about unique people groups. And a waffle depicts that because on every pocket in that waffle, there are barriers, okay? And so if you're like me, I got a real sweet tooth, and it has to be Canadian maple syrup, but we'll go with Aunt Jemima's today. But you gotta fill every pocket, man. Anybody like this with me? You gotta fill every pocket, and then when you're done with the pockets, you gotta douse the whole thing, right? I mean, I've just got such a sweet tooth. But every pocket has to be filled, and you know, those pockets all have barriers. And there are people groups around the world. There are probably between 10 and 24,000, one guy thought, probably more closer to 10 to 12,000 in the world today. And there's probably around 200 countries. But if we look at the world as countries and we send the gospel into places like China, for example, and you hear about 100 million believers, and that's, praise God, awesome, right? 100 million believers. But when you look a little closer, it's mostly among the Han Chinese. And all these pockets, these 400 plus people groups that are different languages, that's one of the barriers, is the language barrier. They speak Han Chinese, Mandarin. They don't, you know, you got the Miao, you got the Chung, you got the Baima, the Western Lolopo. You got all these people groups that speak different languages. Then you've got different religions. You don't just have Confucianism and Buddhism and all those Chinese. You've got animisms, right? You got all kinds of religions. And then there are political barriers, right? There are geographical barriers. People are hidden behind mountain ranges, and it's very difficult to take the gospel to some of these people groups. that are completely unreached. When you came in this morning, got your bulletin, and I chose the countries that your church is focused on, you got a people group from probably Ghana, Thailand, China. There are, and you'll see the statistics on that card, there are people groups who have never heard the name of Jesus. And we've been very successful with pancake theology. We've sent missionaries in every country in the world. But we need to be strategic and think about unreached people groups. We need to think about overcoming language barriers, cultural barriers, political, geographical barriers. Otherwise, we'll just keep pouring the syrup on the pancake. So does that make sense?
Sure does.
That makes sense, doesn't it? Yeah,
absolutely.
So you have to have a waffle theology, and that's kind of setting us up for the message this morning. Now, we need a volunteer to eat that, don't you think?
Yeah.
So anybody want to come up and take, anybody that missed their breakfast this morning, I'm filling all the pockets for you right now, and I'm just about done. Whoever gets up here first gets the waffle, all right? Who wants the waffle this morning? We even have a fork for you. Come on up. Come on up. I saw that hand back there. And I'll bet if you don't want it, your grandfather wants it. Okay? Anybody? She's not bold enough. Nelson, you said you were going to help me out with this. You had a waffle yesterday. You're going to have to take this one from me, too. You'll eat it. Okay, yeah. I know you will. I hope I put enough syrup on here. I've got a real sweet tooth. I like this. That's enough? Okay. All right.
Well, just dump the syrup in your mouth. I mean,
drink it, right? Yeah.
Merle, if you guys want to come up here, worship. Man,
so thank you, Nelson, and thank you for being a faithful father to a lot of us younger ones in terms of the Great Commission. Nelson's one of my heroes, and I love old people, and I hate to call Nelson an old guy, but he's one of those old guys that
he's got gray hair. It looks like you're getting there.
Yeah, I'm getting there, but when I grow up, I want to be like Nelson. Yes. Yeah, amen. So.
All right, thank you, Luke.
Yep.